In this video, we will discuss about the human evolution. So, human evolution. First, we will write the hierarchical division of the human of the humans. Kingdom, Animalia, Phylum, Chordata, Subphylum, Vertebrata, Class, Mammalia, Subclass, Eutheria, Order, Primata, Suborder, Anthropoidy, Superclass is Hominoidy. Sorry, super family, and here family, hominidy, genus Homo, and species Sapiens. So, this is the hierarchy of the humans. They are belonging to the kingdom Animalia, phylum Chordata, subphylum Vertebrata, class Mammalia, subclass Eutheria, order Primata, suborder Anthropoidy, superfamily Hominoidy, family Hominidy, genus Homo, and species Sapiens. So, this is about the hierarchy of the human. Now, we will start the human evolution with the order Primata. So, this Primata order has been divided into two suborders. The first one is Prosimians. The first order is Prosimians, and the second one is Anthropoidy. So, what is the meaning of Prosimians? Prosimians, pro means before, and simian means ape. So, the organisms which were present before apes, they were involved in the suborder Prosimians, belonging to the order Primata. Now, Anthropoidy. Anthro means, or anthropo. Anthropo means human, and oid means like. So, in the suborder Anthropoidy of the order Primata, the individuals which are human like, they have been involved. So the order primata has been divided into the two suborders, prosimians and the anthropoidae. Now we will discuss about the prosimians. Prosimians involve or include three living forms. They are first lemuriforms or lemurs, second lorisiforms or lorisiers, and the third one tarsiforms or tarsiers. These were the three individuals that were belonging to the prosimians or that were present before the apes were evolved. These were the these three individuals belonging to the order primata and the suborder prosimians. So these prosimians were nocturnal animals. This was the first character, that they were nocturnal, and they have large eyes and ears so that they can easily see in night. Nocturnal animals, and they have large eyes and ears so that they can easily see in the night. They have long or elongated nose. Why they have long or elongated like of nose? Due to adaptation. They have the long and elongated type of nose due to the adaptation, because they are very sensitive to the smell. They are very sensitive to the smell. Now these now we will discuss one by one these ones. The first, lemuriforms. These were cat like individuals, or they were cat like animals, and they were insectivorous, insect eaters, and also sometimes they eat fruits, or frugivores. They also used to eat fruits. They were small cat like animals. They were insectivorous and also frugivorous, and they were also having big eyes. Because they were nocturnal, all of these will have the big eyes, and they were found in some part of Africa. Now the lorisiforms, they were also same as lemurs. They were same as lemurs, but they were of somewhat small size. Now the tarsiforms, these were found in the forest of Philippines and East Indies. Tarsiforms were found in the forest of Philippines and East Indies. They were also insectivorous and have big eyes. So this was about the prosimians. They include three individuals: lemuriforms, larciforms, lorciforms and tarsiforms. They were also called as lemurs, lorciers and tarsiers. Lemurs were cat like individuals and they were insectivorous and frugivorous, and they were also having big eyes so that they can easily see in the night, as they were nocturnal, and they were found in some places of Africa. The second one is lorciforms. They were also same as lemurs, but they were somewhat small in size as compared to that of lemurs. And the last one, that is tarsiforms, that were found in the forest of Philippines and East Indies. They were also insectivorous and had big eyes. One more thing in this tarsiforms, they were rat like individuals. They were rat like individuals, and lemurs were cat like individuals. This was all about the prosimians. Now we will discuss about the second suborder of the primata, that is Anthropoidea. Anthropoidea means, anthropo means humans and oid means life. That this order or the suborder Anthropoidea will involve the individuals which are human like. This suborder will involve three super classes, involve the individuals of three super classes. Three super families. Three super families. The first one is Hominoidea. This includes apes and men. The second one is Ceboidea. This will include the New World monkeys. First one, Hominoidea, will include apes and men. The second one, Ceboidea, it will include New World monkeys. And these New World monkeys were also called as Catarrhini. And the third one, Sarcopithecoidea. Sarcopithecoidea, this class will include Old World monkeys, which were also called as Platyrrhini. So there are the three, or we can say that there is first one order, that is primata. From that order primata, two suborders were divided, prosimians and Anthropoidea. Now we are discussing about the Anthropoidea. In that suborder Anthropoidea, it involves three super classes. What are these super classes? The first one is Hominoidea, that we have discussed here also, the super family Hominoidea, evolving from the suborder Anthropoidea. The super family Hominoidea, which includes apes and men. The second one, Ceboidea, which includes the New World monkeys, which were also called as Catarrhini. And the third one, Sarcopithecoidea, which includes the Old World monkeys and which were also called as Platyrrhini. So these were the three classes, and the individuals or the individuals which were present in the anthropoidy that were difference that were showing different from the prosimians in certain characters. So now we will discuss about the characters which were showing the difference from the prosimians. The first character is the teeth. The teeth structure. The structure of the teeth of the anthropoidy that was different from the that was different in both these individuals. That is, the structure of the teeth of anthropoidy is different, and that of the prosimian is different. The second one, brain. In this, we are talking about the cranial capacity. The cranial capacity of the anthropoidy are different, and that of the prosimians is different. The third one, about the skull. Skull of both the individuals belonging to the suborder is different. And the limbs. These limbs are also different. And these anthropoids, they have also developed the color vision. These have also developed the color vision. And the sixth one, these anthropoids, they were diurnal, that is, they remains active during the day and they were inactive during night. So they were diurnal. Diurnal remains active during day and inactive during night. So these were certain characteristics which anthropoids were having, but they were not having in the prosimians. What were these? The tooth structure, they were different in both the individuals of the different suborder. The brain size, or we can say that the cranial capacity of both the individuals were different. The shape of the skull was different. They were having the different types of limbs, and they have evolved, or the anthropoids have evolved the color vision. They were able to see the colors. They have the high power of the perception or the vision, but this was not developed in the prosimians. And the sixth one, or the last one, they were, or the anthropoids were the diurnal. That is, they were active during day and inactive during night. Now, after this, we will discuss the characteristics of these superfamilies, or the individuals which were involving in these three superfamilies. That is, hominoidy, which were involving the apes and the men, and the ciboidy, which were involving the new world monkeys, and sarcopithecoidy, that is, old world monkeys, were present in the super family sarcopithecoidy. Now we will discuss the characteristics of the three super families, the hominoidy, sarcopithecoidy and ciboidy. First we will discuss about the class, super class ciboidy, which were involving new world monkeys, also called as Platyrrhini, These were also called as Caterinae. Now, the New World monkeys. What were the characteristics of the New World monkeys? The first one, they were having a flat type of nose. They were having flat nose. These flat nose that was separated by the wide nostrils. Flat nose separated by wide nostrils. The second one, they were having the prehensile tail. What is prehensile tail? This type of tail. If the individual is having this type of tail, a curve is present in the tail, then it is called as prehensile tail. Why? Because it is used in the balancing. So, this type of tail, this type of curvy tail is called as prehensile tail. So, the New World monkeys, they were having the prehensile tail. Third, New World monkeys have clawed digits. They were having claw in their instead of the nails. The clawed digits were present in the New World monkeys. And these New World monkeys were present in South and Central America. They were found out, or their fossils were generally found out in Central and South America. And the some of the New World monkeys, or the examples of the New World monkeys, are howler monkey, Cebus and spider monkey. These are the some examples of the New World monkey. So, New World monkey, that which is also called as Caterinae, its first character is it is having the wide type of nose, or it is having the flat type of nose which was separated by the wide nostrils. And the second character is they are having prehensile tail, or the curvy tail which helps them in balancing of their body. The third one is clawed digits. They were having clawed type of digits. And one more that which is very important is they were having opposable thumb. Opposable thumb means we have one thumb and four fingers. These four fingers are in one side and this thumb is in opposite side. So, the hand or the limb in which the direction of the thumb is in the different, and the direction of the that is the direction of the limbs or the fingers and the thumb are different, that is called as opposable thumb hand. What is the significance of this opposable thumb? That it helps in holding anything. If we are having the thumb in the direction of the fingers, then we are not able to hold anything. The significance of opposable thumb is that we are able to hold anything properly. So, the opposable thumb is also one character which is present in the New World monkeys. The fifth one, or the another character, is they were present in South and the Central America. And the examples were, or the types of the New World monkeys were, howler monkey, spider monkey and Cebus. Now we will discuss some characters of the next class. Sarcopithecoidae. It involves old world monkeys were involved in this. These were also called as platyrrhini. The first character, these were having flat nose and these were having narrow nose separated by nostrils. Flat nose separated by nostrils and narrow nose separated by nostrils. These were having, new world monkeys were having prehensile tail. These were having non-prehensile tail. Now, the new world monkeys were having clawed digits. They were having claws type of digits. But the old world monkeys were having nailed digits. The fourth one, these were having opposable thumb, but in the new world monkeys they were having non-opposable thumb. Fifth, these were present in Central and South America. They were present in Indonesia, Japan, Africa, etc., and some more places. The sixth one, they were also called as, or some monkeys, examples of the new world monkeys are howler monkey, cebus, and spider monkey. The monkeys which were involved in the old world monkey were baboon, rhesus monkey and langur. This langur, scientific name of this langur is Pisbites. So, what were the characters of the super class Sarcopithecoidae? That they were involving the old world monkeys. These old world monkeys were also called as Catarrhini. The first character of this were, they were having narrow nose which was separated by the nostrils, and they were having non-prehensile tail. That is, they were not having that curvy type of tail for balancing their body. The third one is, they were having nailed claws. Nails were present in their claws. And the fourth one, non-opposable thumb. Their thumb was in the direction of the fingers. And they were belonging to the Indonesia, Japan and Africa. And the few examples of the old world monkeys were baboon, rhesus monkey and langur, whose scientific name is Pisbites. Now, the third class that which we are going to discuss is Homonoidae. The third super class is Hominoidae. This Hominoidae means human like. In this, or this super class includes the individuals which were more human like. Homo means humans and oid means like. So they were including the individuals which were more human like. And this super class Hominoidea has been divided into three classes. The first one is, The first one is Pongidae, and the second one is Pongidae and Hominoidea. These were the two classes which were involved in the super class Hominoidea. So let us discuss one by one both of these classes. The first class is Pongidae. Three individuals were present in this class Pongidae. They were more ape-like. Pongi means ape, and pong means ape, and oid means like. So in this class, ape-like individuals were present, and this involved three larger apes, we can say. The first one is orangutan, gorilla, and chimpanzee. Orangutan, gorilla, and chimpanzee. So let us now discuss some characteristics of these three apes. The first one, that is orangutan, this was somewhat man-like. These were somewhat man-like, and they were having weight around 50 to 100 kgs. These were somewhat man-like, and they were weighted around 50 to 100 kgs. They were called as larger apes. These are the three characteristics of the orangutan. They were somewhat man-like. The second one, they have been weighted around 50 to 100 kgs, and the third one, they were called as larger apes. The second one, or the second animal, or the second ape that we are going to discuss in the class Pongidae is gorilla. Some characters of gorilla: these were weighted around 60 to 80 kgs, and these were also somewhat man-like. They spend most of their time on land. They were weighted around 60 to 80 kgs. They were also somewhat man-like, and they spend most of their time on land. And there was one signature step of the gorilla, we can say, that when in the alarming situation, they used to beat their hand over the chest. so that by performing this type of signature step, they can inform to the other individuals that is, this is the kind of alarming situation, or we have to escape from this situation. Some of the predators have been came to harm us. So this was the alarming type of in the alarming situation they used to perform their signature step. When alarming situation, or during alarming situation, we can say they used to perform their activity, used to beat their hands on chest. So these were the some characters of the gorilla. Now the third one, that is chimpanzee. Men and chimpanzee they are most closest relative. Men and chimpanzees, they are considered as the most closest relatives. Why? Because we have studied earlier also in the evidences of evolution, by the study of the blood proteins and the blood and lymph, and by the study of the blood groups, it have been estimated that the men and chimpanzees, they are the closest relatives and they are having the same origin. Also, they are having same origin. What is the proof that they are having the same origin? The first one is same chromosomal number and chromosomal banding. They are having the same chromosomal number and same chromosomal banding. This is the one proof, or the first proof, that the chimpanzees and men have the common ancestor, or they are having the common origin. The second one is the DNA. The DNA of the men and chimpanzees, they have been differed only by 1.27%. DNA differs only by 1.27% in the nucleotide sequence. Now, the third one, the third evidence that we are talking about is the hemoglobin. Hemoglobin of men and chimpanzee, it have been differentiated only by the single amino acid. Hemoglobin is differentiated by single amino acid. So these are the three proofs that shows that the origin of the chimpanzees and men, they have been originated from the same pathway, or they have been originated from the same lineage. The first one is that their chromosomal number and chromosomal banding are similar. the humans and the chimpanzees, they both are having the same chromosomal number and the same chromosomal bending, and their DNA, the DNA of the chromosome, the DNA of the chimpanzee and human beings, it has been differentiated only by 1.27% in their nucleotide sequences. The third proof is the hemoglobin of both of these individuals is differentiated only by the single amino acid. So these were the three proofs which shows that chimpanzees and human beings have been evolved from the same type of lineage. We were studying the three super classes which were involved in the which have been categorized under the one suborder Anthropoidae of the order Primata. The first order which we have classified was Primata. That Primata was being divided into the two suborders. The first one is Prosimians and the second one was Anthropoidae. Prosimians involved the individuals that were present before apes, and the three individuals were present: Lemuriformes or the lemurs, the Lorsiers and the Tarsiers. The second one was Anthropoidae, human-like animals or the human-like individuals were present, and these Anthropoidae or the suborder Anthropoidae was divided into three superclasses that were Hominoidae, that which involves the humans and the apes or man and the apes. The second one is Ceboidae, which involves New World monkeys, and the third one is Sarcopithecoidae, that involves Old World monkeys. Here we have discussed the characteristics of the New World monkeys, Old World monkeys, and the last one, that is superclass Hominoidae. That superclass Hominoidae is again divided into the three classes, that is Pongidae and Hominidae. Pongidae has three apes, involves three apes, that is orangutan, gorilla and chimpanzees, and chimpanzees are been considered as the closest relatives of the men. And the second class Hominidae, that involves the single living organism. It involves the single living organisms that were Homo sapiens, which was modern man. That is modern man. The class Hominidae involves the single living organism, that is Homo sapiens or the modern man. So this was the brief discussion about the human evolution that we have started from the order Primata. And before discussing about the individuals which have been evolved, like the Dryopithecus, Ramapithecus, which have been evolved from this class Hominidae, we will study afterwards before having the brief discussion or a flow chart of the human evolution.